Hey guys, I wanted to share with you a little bit about telescopes today and how they work for astronomers to gather information about the universe up there. What you're hearing in the background is music by Gustav Holst called The Planet Suite. This particular one is called Mars. At any rate, this kind of simple telescope is called a refractor, and that's because it bends light. So we gather the light up here, and then we bend it down to the eyepiece. So here's a diagram of how this is going to work. So we have this lens, and the light comes into the lens from the light source, and the light is bent to all end up at the same spot, and we call that spot the focal point. And the distance between the lens and that focal point is the focal length. Now, the bigger your lens, the more light you're going to gather, and that's going to allow you to see dimmer objects, and it will allow you to see bright objects more clearly. So a big lens is going to provide you with more light in this refractor telescope. Notice that the light rays are being bent. That's what we mean by refraction. Now, if we want to make a telescope out of this lens, we have to put a second lens at the end of it, the eyepiece lens. So we still have the light coming in. It's being gathered by the objective lens. And then the eyepiece lens magnifies that light, so we have a bigger image. So we have two lenses in this refracting telescope, bending the light. So the light's going to come in here, into this lens, the objective lens inside there. And then as the light passes through the body of the telescope, eventually, it's going to end up at this eyepiece, which magnifies it. Now, I can change this eyepiece, and if I put a different eyepiece in there, the amount of magnification will change. So to get a bigger image, we just change the eyepiece. To get more light, we need a bigger lens than this. And here's all the details about this particular telescope. It tells us that it has a 60 millimeter diameter. That's how big around the lens is. Bigger would gather more light than this. Smaller would gather less. It tells us the focal length, 300 millimeters from the lens to the eyepiece. And then it tells us the magnification. 3 times, 5 times, 26 times, 30 times, 60 and 120 times, depending on which eyepiece you put in there. Now the great thing about a refractor is it's pretty simple. It's just a tube with a lens at one end and an eyepiece lens at the other. This particular one has a mirror in here to bend the light. It makes it a little easier to look through the telescope like this instead of having to go all the way around to the bottom of it. So the reason this mirror is in here to bend the light is just to make it easier to look through. This particular part of the telescope, that's just to help you aim. So when you're looking through a telescope, it's looking at a pretty small patch of sky, and so it's kind of hard to find what you're looking for. So this is a small, it's like half of a binoculars that has a wider field of view, and that helps you to aim and find what you're looking for. And then you look for it through here, you've changed the focus. You can see that the length of the telescope changes when I turn this knob. And that's going to let me to focus on different objects at different distances by changing that focal length. So the negative about a refractor, negatives about refractors are that if you make this lens too big, then it actually gets to be too heavy. The focal length ends up being very long, and you have to have a huge building to house your telescope instead of just putting it on a table like this. Another negative of this is that as these light rays are bent, different colors of light are bent different amounts, and so they end up having different focal lengths. And that means that different parts of the image are in focus in different places, and so you can't really see the whole thing in focus at once. So we get that little distortion going on there from a refractor lens like this. For that reason, astronomers later invented something called a reflector telescope that we'll look at in a minute. All right, chapter 2, reflecting telescopes. So you can see this telescope physically is much larger than the other one we were looking at. And it works differently. It's actually also quite simple. And its whole thing is that it's reflecting light instead of refracting light. Rather than bending it, it's bouncing the light. To do that requires a curved mirror. So, if you have a mirror that is made properly, it gathers light from a single source, and once again, it focuses it all onto a specific point. And that would be our focal point there in the center, where it kind of looks like I've drawn an eclipse. So instead of refracting, instead of bending the light, we're reflecting it with a mirror. But then we have to have a way of getting our head where that point of light is in the middle, at the focal point. And that's why this telescope ends up being kind of large, although simple. So here's how it works. All the light is coming in from one side, and it bounces off the mirror in the back. So we can see over here the light's coming in, and the mirror is back here. This is only the first of two mirrors in this telescope. And this was a telescope invented by Isaac Newton, so we call it a Newtonian reflector. So the mirror is in the back, down here, and all the light bounces off that mirror and goes to the focal point, which is going to be this secondary mirror. That secondary mirror just serves to keep our head from being in the way of the light coming in. Yeah, it blocks off a little bit of light, but not very much compared to the size of the primary mirror. So it just bounces the light, once again, out to an eyepiece, which magnifies our image for us to look at. So let's take a closer look at how this is working on this big telescope here. The advantage of this larger telescope is that it's going to gather more light. So you can see this mirror here. The bigger this mirror in diameter, the more light you're going to be able to gather. You can see those trees in the background and that house bouncing off this mirror, which is a 13-inch diameter mirror. That's going to gather all the light that comes through the telescope. And if we look down the length of the telescope, we see at the end there's a little circle. And that little circle in the middle is the secondary mirror. So we're looking down. This is where the light comes in from where we're looking now. And it goes down to that mirror down at the bottom. And then it bounces back out. And it hits this secondary mirror right here. And when the light hits this smaller mirror, it ends up going to the eyepiece, and that's where you look through. Once again, we're able to change the focus with these wheels so it matches our vision. And once again, to help us aim the telescope, we have a smaller little telescope on the side. This would be a refractor that just helps us find what we're looking for. So if I put this whole thing together, close this up, get that primary mirror in there, and it's just held closed with these screws, and it's all set to be at the right angle to aim all of the light that it gathers onto that secondary mirror, which then bounces all that light to the eyepiece. The bigger the mirror, the more light you gather, and the easier it is to look at dim objects. Let me make sure this is... So, right now, the best thing we have to look at is the sun. And you have to be very careful not to burn your eyeball when you're looking at the sun. So I'm not going to look through here at all. Instead, I'm going to bounce the light into this box. It's my ultra-high-tech solar viewer. And the image of the sun will end up on this paper. So I have to line this up by looking at the shadow. Now, if I'm not careful, I don't know if you can see, but you see that smoke? That's because the sun is starting to burn the inside of the telescope. If that was your eye, ooh, that would be bad, right? There it is. So this, it just looks like a white circle right now, is an image of the sun. Right now we're in a time of low sunspot activity, so we don't really see too much. You can actually see some clouds moving across it, I think. Change the focus a little bit. Yeah. Now sometimes Venus or Mercury crosses in front of the sun, and you can see this perfect black circle in front of this big white circle. There's a sunspot cycle that takes 22 years complete. Right now, we're at a sunspot minimum, so we're not seeing any sunspots. They're kind of cool to look at. Another option is to put a solar filter over the top of the telescope. Notice it's blocking out almost all the light, and then it has this sheet of mylar that allows some of the light to get through, but not all of it. And at this point, it becomes safe to look through the eyepiece directly. I'm also going to change out the eyepiece to be a larger eyepiece. I don't think this one has very much more magnification. Again, we changed the eyepiece to change magnification, but this one just has a much better ability to see fine details. This one does actually have more magnification. And I'm not sure if the camera will work looking through this lens directly or not, but we can give it a try. So you should be able to see the edge of the disk of the sun there. Unfortunately, there are no sunspots to look at the moment. That's what makes the sun more interesting to see. So once again, a reflecting telescope. The light comes through this end. In this case, we're blocking out 99% of it because it's the sun and it's too intense. The light comes down to the bottom where there's that big mirror. It bounces up to the secondary mirror, and that bounces the light to the eyepiece where you can focus it. A reflecting telescope. So this particular one, this is just cardboard and this is just wood. So this is actually one that an amateur astronomer can make. I did not make this. And really the most valuable piece of this whole thing is that mirror at the bottom. And then this objective lens, this eyepiece lens, is also rather valuable. The bigger the diameter, the dimmer the object you can see. And so that makes this telescope slightly better than the other little reflecting telescope that's over there.